Hello students, now I am starting about derivatives parts. I have already discussed the previous sessions about chain rule, that is the very vital part of this derivative. Now we have started the derivative part of the inverse trigonometrical derivatives. So inverse trigonometrical functions derivative is not common for you, but I have told about trigonometrical derivatives, that is derivative of sine x is equal to cos x, derivative of cos x is equal to minus sine x, etc., etc. But now we are discussing about the derivative of inverse trigonometrical functions. There are 6 trigonometrical functions. Now we have starting from sine inverse x, derivative of sine inverse x, derivative of cos inverse x, derivative of tan, and etc. So now formula 1 d by dx of sine inverse x, derivative of sine inverse x is equal to 1 by 1 minus of x square the root over 1 by 1 minus x square root over. Condition that should be mind it, that the value of x, the value of x less than equal to 1. It should be remembered, the value of x, the modulus value of x less than equal to 1. Because if it exceeds 1, for example, taking 2, x is equal to 2 to the square, the square of 2 is 4. So 1 minus 4 is equal to minus 3. Root 2 over minus 3 is not real. It is a complex number. So the value must, mind it, that value must be the modulus value of x less than equal to 1. Similarly, formula 2, d by dx of cos inverse x, d by dx of cos inverse x, that is minus 1. I already told about the function, trigonometric function, we started from the letter C. The trigonometrical function we started the letter C, the result, the derivative part is must be negative, but sine is S, so it is positive, but cos is C, starting from C, so it is negative, same as sine 1 minus x square root over, that is mod x less than equal to 1, same as sine. Similarly, formula 3, d by dx of tan inverse x, the derivative of tan inverse x is very simple to remember, 1 by 1 plus x square. That is not condition of any x. There is no condition like mod x less than equal to a. In this case, there is no condition of any value of x. It may be any real numbers. Okay. Now, formula 4 to going C, starting from C, that is cot d by dx of cot inverse x, d by dx of cot inverse x. The cot inverse x, no doubt, it is starting from C. So the resultant must be starting from a negative, that is from minus, same as tan, 1 by 1 plus x square. Only difference it is, the tan inverse x, derivative of tan inverse x is positive, but derivative of cot inverse x is negative. Next formula 5, now we are discussing, that is only 2 trigonometrical inverse functions, that is d by dx of sec inverse x. Sec inverse x is equal to 1 by x root of x square minus 1, where the value of x, in this case the value of x, mod value of x greater than equal to 1. Similar case, if less than the mod value of x is less than 1, suppose taking s is equal to 0, so 0 square is equal to 0, 0 minus 1 is equal to minus 1, root over minus 1 cannot exist. Cannot a real part exist, but not a real part, it is a complex part. So it is, mind it, that condition must be qualified, mod x must greater than equal to 1. Now the last formula of this trigonometrical inverse functions, derivative of trigonometrical inverse function, is d by dx of cosec inverse, cosec is started from the letter C, no doubt it is negative, minus 1 by x, root 2 of x square minus 1, x greater than equal to 1. That condition must be qualified with the equal to sec. So there are 6 formulas, but we remember only 3 formulas, sine, tan, and sec. So another 3 parts, that is cos, cot, and cosec, are just negative, minus sign is, minus is added, or nothing others. So now in these 6 sessions, now I am starting any one of these problem I have started. You can ask any question. Now let us, I am starting sec inverse x, to prove sec inverse x. How? Derivative of sec inverse x is equal to 1 by x, root over x square minus 1, minus 1. So now we have proved with the formula 5. We have proved only the formula 5. Why I start when I use the formula 5? Because the formula 5 is less, more complicated compared to others. Cosec also same as sec. So, but it is better to formulate how d by dx of sec inverse x is equal to 1 by x of x plus minus 1. Okay, let sec inverse x proved a culture, proof of formula 5. Formula 5 of proof culture. Let sec inverse x is equal to theta, because you already know from inverse part, you already know that the inverse part is a real value and the opposite side is the angle value. If you have interchanges, then inverse is not allowed in the trigonometrical sides. So sec theta is equal to x. So sec theta is equal to x. Now we have derivative d by, using d by dx both sides, d by dx, because the variable is x, not theta, mind it, the variable is x. So we use d by dx, derivative with respect to x of sec theta is equal to d by dx of x. Mindfully look, the variable is theta here, it is the variable x. So using chain rules, what is the chain rule you have used? D by d theta, because that variable is theta, so we have taking theta, d theta. So sec theta into d theta by dx. The using chain rules, divided d theta and multiplied d theta immediately. So d by d theta of sec theta into d theta by dx. You already know d by dx of x is equal to 1. What is the derivative of sec theta? So sec theta derivative is, you already know sec theta derivative is sec theta into tan theta. Sec theta into tan theta into d theta by dx is equal to 1. Just look in these sides. Now d theta by dx, sec theta and tan theta multiplied with d theta by dx. So d theta by dx, sec theta into tan theta divided by 1 by, that is divided in the right sides, sec theta into tan theta. You already know sec theta is equal to x. So d theta by dx, 1 by sec theta. You already know tan theta is equal to sec square theta minus 1. Tan theta is equal to sec square theta minus 1 raw root over. Sec square theta minus 1 root over. So instead of tan theta, we have used sec square theta minus 1. Why we have used? Because we know the value of sec theta is equal to x. Hence, the tan theta changes to sec form. So sec form, that comes to sec square theta minus 1. Now, we have used the value of theta. What is the value of theta? Theta is equal to sec inverse x. So in this case of theta, we used theta. Instead of theta, we used sec inverse x. So that is d by dx of theta is sec inverse x. Sec inverse x plus 1 by sec theta value. Thus the value of sec theta is equal to x. And sec square theta value is equal to x square minus 1. Now that is proof. That is the proof of formula 5. How it is proof? You can look seriously. You can look seriously how it is. Similarly, all remaining, remember all these 5 except sec, other 5, sine inverse, cos inverse, and tan inverse of cosec inverse and cot inverse. You can solve in this way. That process I already proved. So it is not needy to solve this remaining. So now I am starting the problems, problem part, now starting problems. So in exercise, now we are starting exercise. Seven D. We already completed the 7C. The next, the previous session, we already completed 7C. Now I am starting now 7D. What is the 7D? So 7D is, we look number one, question number one. Da dekho. Prove the formulator. Prove the formulator 4 to 7. That is 4 to 7 on the page 212. 212 page 4 to 7. 4 is cos inverse x, tan inverse x, cot inverse and cosec inverse x. I already solved sec inverse x, I already solved. So you can solve that cos inverse x and tan inverse x and cot inverse x and cosec inverse x, that type. That likes, which I have proved that, formula 5 proved. Similarly, you prove cos, tan, cot and cosec. The number one is, that is, you have explained so number one in this type. In this type, that particular, I have done in the number formula 5. You like, you don't remembering all formulas. So now I am starting number two. Number two. Number two is sine inverse 2x. Number two is derivative of sine inverse 2x. Number two. Exercise 7D. Exercise 7D. In your elements books, 7D, sorry, exercise 7D, number 2, d by dx of sine inverse 2x. From 6 formula, the first formula of the 6 formula, that is d by dx of sine inverse x, not 2x. So, in this case, 2x is the multiple angle I have already discussed in the previous session. So, now, you look, d by dx of sine inverse 2x, that problem is created by 2x. So taking 2x as t, using chain rule, d by dt, t as 2x. If t as 2x, though sine inverse t, 2x is equal to t. So sine inverse 2x, according to the chain rule, d by d of 2x is divided, hence it is multiplied, d of 2x divided by x. Look seriously, d by dt of sine inverse t is equal to d by dt of sine inverse t is equal to 1 by 1 minus t square. The value of t is 2x. The value of t is 2x. 2x square root over. If it is x, d by dx of sine inverse x, the formula is, I have already told, 1 by 1 minus of x square root over. In this case, 2x, so 2x square into 2 is the constant, taking outside dx by dx is equal to 1. So 2. How it is done? Remember, 2 is the constant, taking outside dx by dx is equal to 1, 2 into 1 is equal to 2. So now that formula is 2, 2 into 1 is equal to 2, 1 by 2x square is equal to 2x whole square is equal to 4x square, not root 2. That is the answer. That is very easy. You used chain rule. So chain rule is the basic idea of the all the derivatives. So you remember always chain rule. So we have used, that is in case of 2x is the chain rule. So that is self in this case. So similarly, number 3, you look number 3, cot inverse root x, taking root x as equal to t. Number 4, 2x plus sec inverse 2x plus 1, taking 2x plus 1 is equal to t, and using chain rule, you can solve easily. So number 5, already I have done the number 5, and done number 5, you look number 5. Now, number 5, I can solve, I can prove the number 5, how it is, find the value of the derivative, how find our derivative, that is d by dx of cos inverse 1 plus x by 2 root over cos inverse. So that is given. Number 2, you look your books, cos inverse root over whole root over cos 1 plus x plus divided by 2. So now taking using the formula of the chain rule, because cos inverse, we know cos inverse x, the formula of cos inverse x is starting from minus, but in this case taking t as root over 1 plus x by 2. So d by dt t is 1 plus or x by 2 taking t, that is t. So cos inverse of 1 plus x by 2 root over d by dt of cos inverse t, according to the rule of chain rule. So according to the chain rule, that is the d by dt is divided, so hence it is multiplied immediately. D by dt, dt that is 1 plus or x by 2, we know it is a root over function. You look, it is a root over function. In case of a root over function, I already discussion about if it is a root over function without root over taking t. So that is d by dt, t is equal to 1 plus x by 2, without root over. Root over 1 plus x by 2, that is without root over, d by 1 plus x by 2 into, immediately, it is also using chain rule, d of 1 plus x by 2 divided by dx. You look, d by dt of cos inverse t. D by dt of cos inverse t, since it is starting from c, no doubt negative is started. The minus sign is starting from beginning. So 1 minus x square, that root over is not allowed. So 1 plus root over 1 plus x by 2 whole square, that is 1 plus x by 2 whole root over into d by dt of root t. D by dt over root t over d by dx over root x, I already discussed, 1 by 2 root x, 1 by 2 root x, 1 plus x by 2 into 1 by 2 is constant, no doubt, the derivative is 0, x by 2, the derivative of x by 2 is equal to 1 by 2, x derivative 1, so it is equal to 1 by 2. Now we have solved the last line, now we have solved that last line. How we have solved that? Look, seriously look, minus 1y, the LCM is 2, no doubt the LCM is 2, 2 into 1, 2, 2 minus 1 minus x root over by root 2 into 1 by 2 root over 1 plus x by root 2 into 1 by 2, look, root 2 into root 2, 2, you have cancels, root 2 and root 2 cancel. Now, what is the value of 1? 1 into 1 into 1, 1, that is 2 minus 1 is 1 minus x, 1 minus x root over, into 2 is taking out first, and 1 plus x root over, that is 1 plus x root over. Look, this 2 minus 1 is 1 minus x, 2 taking out from starting, then root over 1 plus x. Root over 1 minus x whole into root over 1 plus x, that equal to 1 by 2, 1 minus x square. That is your answer. I have discussed again, clarify how it is done. That is the formula number question number 5. D by dx of a cos inverse of root over 1 plus x by 2. Again, you look, again I have a discussion about it clearly, how it is. The answer is 1 by 2 root over 1 minus x square, it is coming. Look, d by dx of a cos inverse of root over 1 plus x by 2. Now, since it is root over, we know the formula cos inverse x, not cos inverse root over 1 plus x by 2. Hence, we have used the chain rule. So, taking 1 plus x by 2 root over using taking t. So, d by dt of a cos inverse t. So, immediately that dt is multiplied, it is a root over function without root over taking t. Then it is also multiplied and dx. So it is three step using chain rules. Now d by dt of a cos inverse t, d by dt of a cos inverse t, since it is cos is starting from the letter c, so it negative sign is starting. Then 1 by 1 minus x square, that is t square 1 plus x root over 1 plus x by 2 root square is root over, which cancels. So 1 minus of 1 plus x by 2 into d by dx, that is the t, d by dt of root over t is equal to 1 by 2 root over of t. So 1 by 2 root over of t into 1 by 2 is no doubt constant. I only say the fundamental formula, that's the any constant, derivative of any constant is 0. So derivative of half is 0. Now remaining x by 2. So x by 2, 1 by 2 is taking the constant common outside, derivative of x is equal to 1. So that is 1 by 2. Next, that is 1 minus 1 plus x by 2 row whole root over, taking 2 as LCM, least common multiple or loss agu. So 2 is that is root over 2. Root over 2 is 2 is multiplied here. 2 minus 1 minus x, because minus sign is from beginning zone, the sign of the interval also changes. So 2 minus 1 minus x by root 2, root over 2. Similarly, 2 of 1 plus x root over by root 2 into 1 by 2, root 2 into root 2 is 2 into 2, got it? So it will be 2 minus 1 dala 1 minus x, 2 tag from beginning start to kill. 1 minus x root over into 1 plus x root over. 1 minus x whole into 1 plus x, you already know 1 minus x square. Root over is common to both, hence answer is 1 by 2 root over 1 minus x square. Number 5 is completed. Now I am going to number 6. Also number 6, I have done also number 6, because that is also one of the complicated. Now I am starting number 6. Number 6 is you look number 6. What is the question? Number 6 is given. That is cos inverse, derivative of cos inverse x minus 1 by x divided by x plus 1 by x. That is d by dx of cos inverse x minus 1 by x whole divided by x plus 1 by x. When using, that is, you already always remember, when using derivative, bracket must be used. Without bracket is meaningless. When you apply derivative, any functions, you must use bracket. That bracket I have used, always I have used brackets. So you, that's remembering, that bracket must be used. Otherwise, it is meaningless. The derivative is meaningless. So next, that is LCM is x, d by dx of cos inverse x into x, x square minus 1 by x. In denominator side, also LCM is x, x into x is equal to x square plus 1 by x, that x, x is cancelled. So that is d by dx of cos inverse x square minus 1 by x square plus 1. Look, that is similarly, that previous question, that is similarly, that is t, using t, cos inverse t, because I know the formula, but we know the formula of cos inverse x, not cos inverse x square minus 1 by x square plus 1. So that totally, that bracket part taking as t, that bracket part taking as t. So taking d by dt is equal to x square minus 1 by x square plus 1 into cos inverse x square minus 1 by x square plus 1. We have used, that is d by dt, according to the chain rule, that d by dt is immediately multiplied after this step. So d of x square minus 1 by x square plus 1 divided by dx. You look, you have a question, sir, again we have used chain rule. No, we can derivative by division formula for derivative, we can use this formula. So our not necessity of using another step of chain rule. The previous question I have is 3 steps, but it is 2 steps. Look, d by dt of a cos inverse t is equal to, since cos is c, starting letter is c, so negative sign is must be come first, minus is coming first. So d by dt of 1 minus 1 by 1 minus of t square is x square minus 1 by x square plus 1 square, no, whole root over, into d by dx of, that is using division formula of derivative is equal to, that is algebra of derivative, I have already discussed about it. So now the second denominator function x square plus 1 is a constant, derivative of numerator functions x square minus 1 माइनस नॉट प्लस माइनस न्यूमरेटर इज ए कॉन्स्टेंट एंड अ डेरिवेटिव ऑफ डिनोमिनेटर फंक्शन होल डिवाइड बाय डिनोमिनेटर फंक्शन नो स्क्वायर होल डिवाइड बाय डिनोमिनेटर फंक्शन नो स्क्वायर लुक इन दिस स्टेप लुक दैट इज द वाइटल पॉइंट नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग नाउ द मेन पॉइंट वी आर डिस्कसिंग लुक द एलसीएम इज एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन स्क्वायर द एलसीएम इज एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन स्क्वायर सो दैट इज मल्टीप्लाइड विथ वन दैट बिकेम्स वन बाय माइनस वन बाय सॉरी माइनस वन बाय एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन स्क्वायर माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस वन स्क्वायर डिवाइड बाय एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन वाई यू यूजिंग एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन बिकॉज द रूट ओवर इज विदाउट रूट ओवर द स्क्वायर रूट ओवर इज कैंसल सो एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन इनटू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन इज कॉन्स्टेंट एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस वन टाइम सिंस वन इज ए कॉन्स्टेंट द डेरिवेटिव इज जीरो सो एक्स स्क्वायर डेरिवेटिव एक्स स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू एक्स माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस वन इज कॉन्स्टेंट एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन एक्स स्क्वायर डेरिवेटिव टू एक्स वन डेरिवेटिव जीरो टू एक्स डिवाइडेड बाय एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन स्क्वायर दैट इज गोटे वन स्क्वायर पार्ट इज वन स्क्वायर पार्ट इज कैंसल रिमेनिंग एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन नाउ माइनस वन ए प्लस बीरो स्क्वायर माइनस ए माइनस बीरो स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस बीरो स्क्वायर होल इंटू ए माइनस ए माइनस बीरो स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू फोर ए बी फोर एक्स स्क्वायर अगेन आई एम रिमेनिंग योर हाई स्कूल टैक्स ए प्लस बीरो स्क्वायर माइनस ए माइनस बीरो स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू फोर ए बी फोर इंटू एक्स स्क्वायर इंटू वन फोर एक्स स्क्वायर इंटू टेकिंग बोथ साइड टू एक्स कॉमन That is x square plus 1 minus x square plus 1 divided by x square plus 1. Plus x square minus x square cancels. So 1 into 1 is 2. 2 into 2x will be 4x minus 4x. Root over 4x square is equal to 2x whole into x square plus 1. X, x cancel. 4 cancel. That is minus 2 by x square plus 1. That is answer. That is the answer. Remember that point. A plus B whole square minus A minus B whole square is equal to 4AB. Here A is equal to X square and B is equal to 1. 4 into X square into 1 is equal to 4X square root over 4X square. That is root over 4X square is equal to 2X. In this case, you taking common 2X, both side 2X, X square plus 1 minus X square plus 1 because negative sign before the brackets, so in between the brackets, all the signs are changes. Plus x square is equal to minus x square and minus 1 is equal to plus 1. Hence, x square plus x square and minus x square cancels. 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So 2 into 2x is equal to 4x. xx cancel. 4 by 2 is equal to 2 because the negative sign is equal to previously already posted. So minus 2 by x square plus 1, that is your answer. Number 6 already completed. Now we are going to number 7. Yes, I am already done number 7 for you because number 7 must be create some problems for you. Now I am starting number 7 and number 8 and number 10. Last three questions I have doing, but number 9 and 11 you can do. So number 7 now, starting number 7. Thank you.